Hello, Gundam fans. This is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 10144 High Grade Zaku Amazing from the Gundam Build Fighters series. So it's a modified version of the newer High Grade Zaku that we have, and looking pretty good. A lot more wine color, which does really look good on the overall suit design. You do have new parts on the backpack here, new shoulder pieces, new leg armor. Everything else is pretty much the same as you have on the other Zakus. And pretty nice and solid, especially because of these little thingies here, which I'm still not 100% what they are. But they do help keep it on the ground. But it was pretty solid as it was, like, without those. So it's pretty nice. And now stickers for this model? The eye. That's it. And I'm really happy with that. And they have changed some of the colors, like the elbows. The hands are the wine, but you do have a lot of other ones with the actual pink color, if you want. But yeah, good looking kit. Same, mostly the same as the other, with a few new pieces that does change up a bit. I do like it. It is a nice variation to the normal Zaku we get. The head does rotate a little, and a little forwards and back. Of course, you do have the mono-eye gimmick, or if you move the little lever, you can move the eye. So that's standard stuff. The arms go forwards and back, and they can rotate, and the shoulder armor can rotate. It's on a polycat ball joint, but it doesn't really swivel, like, it only swivels, it doesn't move, like, anymore, really. These little things can move. The arms will rotate below the shoulder, and they will move out. Not that far. They bend the elbow at one joint, ball jointed wrist. You do have a ball jointed waist, which it does have the little gaps in the hosing here, so you can get a little bit of movement. Actually, it's pretty good. Not much rotation, but a good wiggle here. Front skirts can move, side skirts are limited because of the hosing. And you do the forward and back, no jiggy jig, but just forward and back. Legs go forward. Can't go back, really. Can go out some. Rotate a little at the hip, because they're not, like, circular. Double jointed knee, but pretty limited. Of course, these little flappy things can move, and the foot can go forwards and back at the joint up in the ankle, and then the ball-jointed foot. And there is a little bit of a hinge there, too. A little flip-flop action, so. And, of course, a little ball-jointed thruster. So, yeah, it's decent. It is limited, but Zaku's tend to be limited with the way they are designed with the hosing. Although you'd think that since this is supposed to be that guy's custom, I think he would have gotten rid of that hosing, give him more mobility. Whatever. I would have, but, oh well. It's still, it's not too bad, really, for a Zaku articulation. Now, the Zaku does have, this one has all the accessories that the old one has. So you've got the machine gun with the moving scope handle. You can pull off the clip, and you do have an extra one. You have the Heat Hawk, exactly the same, and you have the same bazooka with the movable scope and handle. Now you also have the extra some extra armor. You got the shield, which I have mounted the clip, which you can put all the accessories onto it. Just like the other versions I've shown lately. You do have extra leg armor, which are like the those few variants I've done. It is missing the little pipe that goes here. It does have all the thrusters, so if you want, you can use it if you don't like that armor. You do get the spike for the shoulder, but you're missing the top one, so that's a little out of place. And you also get a different colored chest piece, the flat helmet, without the hole for the antenna, and you also get the normal antenna, or not the normal one, but the more detailed one, which I can't find, but it's same as the other kits. And then you get quite a few hands. These ones are holding ones, which have holes in them for the melee weapons, but then you get quite a few more. You've got closed fist for the just for the left hand. And you've got a set of trigger finger hands, which are angled a little bit. And then you have a set of holding hands without the pegs. And these all have the pink ones. So these are a little different and a little out of place because you don't get extras, but you can switch them around if you so choose. Now the new stuff. Well, you've got a set of missile launchers, which are on a ball joint, and these little connectors, now you can put them right here. There's an indent, which will fit these. So if you want, you can stick them, and they show us all the instructions, so you can stick these on the legs. Like that. And they're pretty solid, surprisingly. Or, where they're normally supposed to go, is up here on the backpack. Like that. And now they can move up and down and still do the rotation and everything. So, that's nice. Now you've also got a pair of, not sure exactly what they're called. They're probably called heat hatchets. That's what they look like anyways. They do heat up in the anime. And they have little pegs, because you can take these hands and peg them in. Right like that. Pretty nice. I do like these. And nice storage right back here. Just slides right in. And there we have it. I like that. Very nice. And then we have these holsters, which hold the... They look definitely look like revolvers. Little revolvers. Very nice. Once again, they have the peg on either side. So you can use them in either trigger finger hand. Let me find the one for the left hand. There we go. So once again, just peg it in. You think because the peg holes are longer than the actual pegs, it would be a problem, but no. They still fit rather well. I think they'd be like kind of sliding or loose, but no. And let's give it a little revolver. Revolver Zaqualot. And to mount these, the same place you would put like the heat hawk or the extra ammo clip. You got a little hook here and then it pegs it. It's not the most secure ever. Maybe if you cut the little peg, it goes into a little closer, so it is closer to the skirt. But it's okay, and more of the maroon color is a nice welcome thing. And you can see now the hand covers are different, so I have to like pop the hand cover off and switch it with another one. And there we go. Now I do wish they had used different hands because these ones are angled, like I said, and you don't really need them for this, the pistols. But you can easily just kind of move it over a bit. That's not too bad. And finally, you have this weapon right here, which I'm not totally sure what it's called. Some kind of cannon. Has a little movable handle, which is a spike, for some reason. And another one here, which does have the peg, just like before, so you can put it in either hand. And it has two holes here. I assume these holes are for the Zaku booster, which you I don't think you can make with this. It doesn't show it in the instructions. I think you need an extra piece. At least I think. Unless you can use the backpack. I don't know. But it doesn't show it on the instructions I got, so I don't know. Although, if you want, you could use it on the shield connector here and put it into this part. It does stress the plastic a bit because it's a little too big. But you can use this little drum and clip it onto here. And it does hold. And then you can put everything else onto the shield. And if I plugged it in right, you put the bazooka there, and you can put the machine gun on this side, and then you can take the heat hawk, and you can totally have it on here. And then, I mean, this will work. I've tried it. Peg it in like that. So all of a sudden you have a super, like, look at that. He is super ready for battle. He is so full of weapons. It's crazy. It's amazing. So, yeah, I mean, this is an anime built around customizing your mobile suits. Well, there you go. He's ready to go. But let's just take that off and put it back the way it's displayed on the anime. So yeah, accessories are really good. I like all of them. Having all the old ones, all these nice new ones. Like I said, the holders for the pistols are a little loose. They're not too bad. But other than that, I really like these accessories. Pretty good stuff. Now let's compare the Zaku Amazing to some other versions of the new Zaku 2. So we got the, I think it's the Mitsunaga Custom, and the Earth Federation version from Stardust Memory. And you can see, based on the base mold, just variations of an armor here and there, pretty good. Pretty different. You got some good army of Zakus here. And gotta compare it with the other mobile suit in this line I've got so far, the Build Strike. So they're about even height, I'd say. About. Zaku might be a smidge taller at the head. So yeah, that is the Zaku Amazing. It's pretty amazing. I like it. It has a lot of good accessories, which you can, if you want, put them all on them at once. It's got decent articulation for a Zaku. Nothing's really hindered by the new equipment. You can change some of the equipment if you want. Like I said, you are missing a few pieces here and there for it to be a complete Sharazaku. Like, or, well, these are totally different, but as a complete other Zaku. And it's got good colors, and only... Oh, and there was another sticker. Forgot the other sticker. Right tucked in there. It's a metallic purple. You can barely see it. So yeah, that's the only other sticker. Very minimal on that. All plastic color. If you don't want to paint it, it still looks good. So pretty decent kit. And it is the second one in the line, and it's pretty good. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.